Hey, welcome to the channel. My name is Eric, and today we're going to talk about batteries, knowing which battery to buy for your machine. So, maintenance as well. So stay tuned. So welcome back to the channel. My name is Eric. We do the weekday Monday through Friday, and that's available on podcast as well. And we try to do some educational videos like we're doing today. Today we're going to talk about batteries. And the thing that you have to keep in mind is the cold cranking amps. You need to know what your lawnmower takes for to get adequate crank on your engine. The bigger the engine, the more cranking amps you want, so you can turn it over. If you don't, it'll start getting hot on the post because you don't have enough juice to spin it the way it should. So the thing you want to look at is right here, and this is a 300 cranking amp. It's a U1 group size. And the other thing you have to keep in mind is John Deere is usually just the opposite. So when you're buying a battery, you have a positive here, a negative here. On a John Deere, they're reversed. And that's the way they sell them to at Walmart. So don't worry about it. Just make sure that you have the right one on, or you're going to have to extend your one of your posts to get the length. The other thing is size. Look and see how much room you've got for a battery compartment on your lawnmower. Some take batteries of half the size. And an example of that, you know, when you start talking your four-wheelers and, let me grab a different battery. But with your four-wheelers, your motorcycles, all your other ones, you see how thin that battery is and how thick? This one is not going to go into this battery box for here, right? And then the other thing you want to keep in mind is, I get this asked a lot. When you buy a lawnmower battery at Walmart and it's maintenance free, most often the case, they've got a charge on them. And they've got enough of a charge on them, so it'll start your unit. And as long as your stator and your charging system is working right, your voltage regulator, that it will bring up that while you're mowing. And then you have some that they ship what they call dry. And they send the acid right with them. These here will require a charge. Now, this can be very corrosive. So, you know, I should be wearing rubber gloves and all the other stuff. But they send the battery acid like this. And then they send this little tube, and then they send the bolts and nuts to go to it. You're just going to take each cap out. Just like that. Pop them out. And then what you're going to want to do is cut this plastic. And then you want to just take and cut the nipple. Just like that. Now, inside your package, comes with a tube. They tell you to connect the red tube. So we'll take and fit the red tube over top. And then what you're going to want to do is start here. You just want to keep doing that and watching the fill on the back. You can see with it coming up. And if you get too full in one, it'll just run over into the other. But it will start self-leveling all by itself. So once you have that done, you have your posts that are in here, but before you do any of that, you're going to want to take and put a low, I call it low and slow. Take 3 6-amp, somewhere in that neck of the woods, and let it sit, and let it just slowly charge itself up, because it comes as a dry unit, right? So the battery acid has got to come in contact with the plates that are in there, and then it will take a charge and hold the charge. So remember, check your owner's manual on your lawnmower to make sure you have the correct cranking amp, the correct battery size to fit where it belongs. And always remember, John Deere usually has opposite posts. So if you go to Walmart and you're going to swap out your John Deere battery, take it with you and compare to make sure that your posts are the same. So on that note, you guys have a great day.